not be taught in textbooks. It's something that most people who come here will not speak to you about. I was at his house when he first hit me. We hadn't fought or argued. In fact, I was studying for my exam. He pushed me against the wall, grabbed my neck, tried to choke me, slapped me, punched me, spat on me, called me names, and tried to break my back. This was 8 years ago, when the man that I loved and wanted to spend the rest of my life with hit me for the first time, and continued to do so for the next 5 years. Now, I'm a storyteller by profession. I tell stories of love, of longing, and of hope. Because it's very difficult to tell the story, and it's very difficult to listen to it. Yet this is a story that has to be told and has to be heard. Because 33% of women in India are victims of physical abuse and domestic violence. That is over 20 million women, the entire population of Australia. This also means that one in every three women that you meet has either undergone physical abuse or will undergo physical abuse. In fact, I can guarantee you this, that one in every three women sitting here in the auditorium today is either being hit by someone she loves, her father, her brother, her boyfriend, her husband, or will be hit at some point. It's a very, very sad state of affairs for our country. It's almost an epidemic. Yet nobody talks about it. The worst part is, according to a UNICEF study, that more than 50% of boys and girls in our country think that it is justified for a man to hit a woman. And I'm not just talking statistically here today. When I finally found the courage to write about what I've gone through in July of this year, I received an outpouring of messages. A dancer wrote to me and said that her boyfriend had broken her spine. She couldn't dance anymore. A theatre actress called me up and said her ex-husband had thrown her out of a moving car. Many, many of my college mates wrote to me and said that they had been abused. One of them told me that she had been in two physically abusive marriages. It is an epidemic in India, and we need to start addressing it. We need to stop the violence. Now, why should a man not hit a woman? For obvious reasons, right? It's unethical, it's wrong, it's sinful. But I don't think we think about the consequences as much as we should. When a man slaps a woman, when he punches her, when he pushes her, when he kicks her, it can lead to her death. A woman can be maimed, she can be injured, she can die with simple acts of violence. It has happened to millions of women before, accidental deaths, millions and millions of women before, even when a man did not intend to kill a woman. When I was hit the second time, my abuser flung me across the bed. I went flying across the bed and landed on my neck. I fainted. When I think of it now, I realize that if I had landed an inch to the left or to the right, I would have broken my neck that day and died in a matter of a few seconds. Even though my abuser never intended to kill me, these are the consequences of hitting a woman, and a man should know this. It's not just the physical abnormality of it, but even the emotional toll that it takes on a woman. You don't just injure her or cripple her for life. You cripple her emotionally. You take away the spirit of life that she holds. I used to be a very, very happy person. I engaged with the world. I engaged with life. But when I was hit, my abuser made sure to play a lot of mental games with me. Because you see, physical abuse comes with emotional abuse. He demeaned me, criticized me. He told me that I was provoking him into hitting him. He told me that I deserved it, that I had asked for it, much less made it to me. And you know what? I slowly started believing him. He told me that I'm a terrible person, that I did not deserve to be loved. I did not deserve to be a good, a happy person. stopped laughing. I started crying a lot. I would be crying all the time. I would be walking on the road and just weeping. I would cry in front of complete strangers. I felt so helpless. I felt depressed. I didn't know who to turn to. I didn't even want to get away.
No, remember.
This is what a man does to a woman when he gets hurt. We must not let the daughters of India, the sisters of India, the mothers of India be engaged like this in physical abuse and domestic violence. A man should not hit a woman. This world needs more love. It needs more hope. It needs more dreams. No man should kill a woman's dream. We should teach the daughters of India. You must teach all your sisters, your friends, your cousins. Teach your mothers, teach your sisters that their body, their mind, their spirit, their heart, none of this should ever be taken for granted. No man should hit a woman. And if he hits her the first time, she should leave him, no matter what the consequences. More than stopping the violence, though, we women become the repositories of shame in this matter. And in this way, by not speaking about what we go through, we start perpetrating this crime. In India, it's considered a shameful thing to talk about domestic violence. It's considered a private matter, something that should remain within the four walls of the house, a domestic matter. And this is where we as women go wrong. We have to stop the violence, and we have to, most importantly, stop the silence. We cannot prevent millions of men who hit the millions of women, but women can fight back with very, very simple steps. The first thing, stop the silence. I keep reiterating this because it seems like a very simple thing to do. What's the big deal in talking about it? It took me 8 years. It's a very difficult thing to talk about, but it's a very, very powerful step when you do talk about it. If you are hit, you have to go and talk to someone, whether it's your parent, your cousin, your best friend. You have to talk about it. Tell someone. But more importantly, first identify if you are in an abusive relationship. And it sounds very silly. Of course you know if you're in an abusive relationship. But the surprising thing is, most women don't. Because we don't talk about it. When I finally spoke about it, a best friend of mine told me that unless a man sends it to the hospital, it does not constitute physical violence. This is where we as a society are so wrong. Abuse is defined as a slap, a punch, a kick, using weapons, threatening to use weapons, threatening to inflict violence or harm somebody. All of these come under the gamut of physical abuse. So do not fool yourself into thinking that you're not being abused when you are. The other thing you must know is that even if your abuse is not as bad as what is shown on TV or in movies or what you read about in newspapers, it is still abuse. Do not become a statistic. Now we know that you understand today what abuse is, but how do you identify an abuser? You know, we are creatures of the heart. We are set up in this world to love and to be loved. But before getting into a relationship with anybody, my advice to you would be to be a little circumspect. Be a little bit careful. There are red flags that you must watch out for. And of course, not a Bible, but it's something that you must keep in mind. An abuser will typically be somebody who has a huge temper tantrums, who throws huge temper tantrums, has anger management problems, is vindictive, he's petty. He will keep trying to inflict criticism on you, inflict damage on you. He will think that the whole world is out there to get him. These are red flags. Always be circumspect about these. Do not take them lightly. An abusive man will have either a history of abusing other people. My abuser, for instance, sent a schoolmate of his to the hospital for 6 months. And he told me about this. And at that time, I was so naive, I didn't realize the consequences of a man who already hit someone and sent them to the hospital. Be careful. If there's a history of physical abuse in the family, if he's seen his father with his mother or his uncle with his cousin, be a little bit careful. But of course, you cannot avoid everything. If you find yourself in an abusive relationship, which one in three women, one in three of you is going to at some point in your life, very sadly, what should you do? If you know someone who's in an abusive relationship, what should you do? Stop the silence. I keep reiterating this. Small but powerful step. Tell someone, somebody whom you love, somebody whom you trust. Tell your abuser that you've told this person, because it immediately forms a protective barrier between you and your abuser, because he knows now that you have a witness to the crime. Then speak to your abuser. If he is willing to acknowledge his mistake and change, then by all means carry on. Continue the relationship, go to a psychiatrist, seek help, and hopefully you'll be able to walk into the sunset. But it's a distinct hope we all cling to, that the one you love will change for the better. It rarely happens. The fact is that the man is hitting you, he does not respect you. He's not going to take your problems. What should you do then? Get out of the house. No matter what you do, create a distance between your abuser and yourself. Block his calls, block him on Twitter, block him on Facebook, block his emails. Make sure you're not accessible to him. If you are married, make sure that you cannot reach out to your children. Take your children with you. Because otherwise, he's threatening violence against them. Go to a social worker. There are lots of NGOs who help people like this. There's a Domestic Violence Act of 2005 that you can use. You can go to the police and report a statement. If you've been hospitalized, do ensure to report a statement at the hospital itself. There are lots and lots of people out there to help you. You know, the first step always seems hardest. You will feel like, I cannot do this. You will find a million excuses to stay in an abusive relationship. I know I will. Your abuser will come weeping to you. He will tell you, you are my savior. You're the only person who will save you from this big bad world. He will weep in front of you. Do not believe his lies. This man is an animal. This man does not love you. He does not respect you. Leave him. I beg of you. You will cry a lot, for weeks, for months, for years. You feel confused and angry and hopeless. You feel a whole array of emotions. You may get into depression. But trust me, after some time, you feel like this weight is lifted off your shoulders. You will start smiling again. You will start laughing again. You may even fall in love again. Or not, it doesn't matter. Understand that it has a positive ending. Leaving an abusive relationship is not an event though, it's a process. So be patient, be brave, be strong. I want to ask all of you today to promise me to stop the violence and to stop the silence. The men sitting in the auditorium today, I beg you, with all sincerity, do not ever raise your hand at home. You cripple her, not just physically, but also emotionally. Don't do this. We need more love in the world. We don't need more broken limbs. We do not need more broken lives. We do not need more broken hearts. So please, I request you to chant after me. Stop the violence. Please chant after me, the boys. Stop the violence. Thank you so much. And to the girls in the auditorium, and to the girls watching this, if you ever find yourself in a physically abusive relationship, get out of it. Your life is more valuable than anything else in this world. And I beg you, stop the silence. Don't keep quiet about it. I suffered for 8 years because I did, and I beseech you, don't repeat my mistakes. You'll find a lot of love out there. You'll find a lot of support. So I ask you very humbly to repeat after me and promise me today that you will stop the silence. Please repeat after me. Stop the silence. Thank you so much. You know, this kind of silence is very difficult to break. It's very hurtful to talk about. But it is even more hurtful if you don't talk about it. Because this silence has a bully. And the bully's name is violence. And we need to stop the violence. We need to stop the silence. Thank you very much.